What would terrorists want with an ugly-looking submarine?
Is what's on the inside that counts, Eleven?
You've got to be kidding me.
I'm deadly serious, actually. This is a Code Red arms movement.
Meaning?
Meaning the military are transporting a nuclear weapon from one base to another with very high consequences if it all goes wrong.
You would think they could protect themselves if that happened. Why do they need our help?
They're US military personnel, Eleven. Not exactly trained to be low-key.
Okay. But this is the fourth arms movement I've overseen this week. Couldn't we get an intern to do it?
Agent 11, the arms movement's earlier this month for all low risk. You really think I'm going to trust a rookie with Code Red movement? No offence.
None taken.
Well, I suppose things have been a little bit too quiet recently. Though, I still think they can handle it themselves.
It's almost like you want to start a war, Agent 11. They've hardly got a brain cell between them. Stick a terrorist in there and they turn into a random killing machine. Whereas you, you're more of a...
personal statement.
Niko, move in now! Agent 11, that cargo bomb is priority one.
What about the nuke?
On board the helicopter is a data ship. Not only does it contain the launch codes, but also a backup of the complete FIB database. If they get their hands on it, we're sitting ducks.
Professor, you need to shut down the onboard computer and ground the nuke.
Yes, I got that, thank you very much.
What are you waiting for?
Professor, I need you to drop this up now!
I'll do my best, Eleven.
The chip, Agent 11. You have no idea about the gravity of the situation.
Actually, Mark, I think gravity is exactly what I'm worried about right now.
Focus, Eleven.
We Would you be focusing if you were dangling from a flying metal bird at 10,000 feet? No, didn't think so.
What was that, 11? We couldn't hear you.
I said, yes, ma'am. You can count on me. Oh my.
What's going on?
It appears I'm not the only one who's unhappy with their position. The pilot's getting nervous. I'm sorry, ma'am.
What? Niko, I'm warning you, don't you dare!
Sorry, mate. I'm not really one for hanging about.
Oh, Father, tell me, do we get what we deserve? Oh, we get what we deserve. And way down we go, oh, 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 oh. And way down we go, oh, 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 oh. Say way down we go, oh no. Time has come as we all go down. Yeah, but for the fall, my, do you dare to look him right in the eyes? Oh, and they will run you down, down to the dark. And they will run you down, down to you fall. They will run you down, down to your core, yeah, till you can't crawl no more. And way down we go, oh, oh, oh. And way down we go, oh no, oh. Say way down we go. Down to your core and way down we go. Way down we go. Way down we go. Down we go.
Weasel News.
Breaking news.
Weasel has exclusive HD 3D surround sound coverage.
And following on from our top story today, the FIB has been put under heavy fire again after terrorists managed to storm a secure military base that was under the FIB's watch. It is believed that the people responsible for this attack also managed to hijack a military helicopter, though this is unconfirmed. Sources indicate that...
In other news, the Internal Affairs Agency has finished its investigation into the terrorist incidents that occurred in Los Santos by the organization titled Honor.
I've done all the research, and let me tell you, this election is going to be unlike anything that's gone before. The Democrats' President Morrison is running for a second term. The Republicans have their candidate hoping to score high, business tycoon and entrepreneur William Fitzgerald.
However, this is not the biggest surprise of them all. The current Secretary of Homeland Security, Robert Pierce, is standing as an independent. In his words, it's his aim to revolutionize politics here in the United States.
Earlier today, the director of the FIB, Claudia Angel, addressed the incident that took place at the Southern Docks of Los Santos. Here is what she had to say.
This act of terrorism was preordained and coordinated by a terrorist group hell-bent on gaining access to the United States' nuclear arsenal. Well, I can safely say to the American people, their attempt did not result in success. My agents performed their duty and stopped them before they could gain access. However, as we know, an FIB helicopter was stolen by the attackers. Of course, I am unable to comment on an ongoing investigation, but what I can tell you is that I have sent my best agents to investigate.
Discretion. That's how you succeed in this business.
Oh, and I suppose that's completely inconspicuous.
Look, kid, if we're going to recover this chip that contains enough intelligence to make the professor look like a reality TV star, then we need to look the part.
Look the part for what, exactly?
It's simple. I'm going to walk in, talk very quickly, convince them that I'm an exec from whoever the hell they work for, then get out there before the idiots can work out what happened.
And that's supposed to work, is it?
A friend of mine tried something similar once.
Oh really? And how did you work that out?
The divorce cost him more than he expected.
We need to pick up the pace. The meeting is in an hour. I'm still not convinced this is a good idea.
Put that cold foot of yours down, and we'll soon find out.
Nice of you to join us, Mr. Bellic. We have the data chip. Now I would like the codes to use it.
What makes you think that we know them?
You're on your way to make some kind of deal, I presume. Even the U.S. negotiates with terrorists if they can't cover up the consequences. They are always four steps behind. Silent still, Mr. Bellic? gun. Now. I found this gun to be very persuasive in the past. In fact, there are guns very similar to this. One is currently between the eyes of your wife and child.
Now who's four steps behind?
Not you. You.
No. No, please.
Tell me the codes.
I can't. I'm sorry. I don't know the code.
And I just don't believe you.
Let him and his family go. If you have the chip, then you know about the FIB. And if you know about the FIB, you know who I am.
You. Make the call. Have her shot.
No. No, please. Please. The code... the code is... 191... 131... 319... 14.
Well, that wasn't so hard after all, was it?
No, no, please. Please.
Let's get out of here.
Boss.
Thank you.
offer.
You have an incoming call from 0718152512.
Hello?
Mission failed, Agent.
Who are you?
All in good time. For now, you'd better get back to the FIB. A storm is heading their way, and I'm not sure it's rain. You've spent years telling people you are the Lord Bellic.
How do you?
But you're not above it.
Do you know what the biggest lie of the 21st century is? That the state has maximum power. Well, that's a lie. It's the institutions that protect society that hold the most power, yet it is something the state abuses, ridicules, ignores. History has taught us that even the most powerful of tyrants fall, and they fall for one reason and one reason only: an uprising of the people. So that is what we orchestrate. We break the old to recreate the new. We operate in the shadows to control the light. In other words, we are the Black Phantom. Congratulations. You've all made it this far, which means each and every one of you have sacrificed something. Beautiful. One of you, and only one of you, will become an apprentice in Black Phantom, but that means you must fight for it. You must want it. If not, then you are eliminated.
Sir, when do we get the opportunity to meet the boss?
What's your name, kid?
Whitfield, sir.
Well then, Whitfield, you should all know two things. One, you address the man in charge with General. And two, you must never, ever disturb him when he is present. You got that?
Yes, sir. Of course, sir.
I did not want to know that. Before I go and see to this business, only one of you can pass this test. So, the first one to get the other in the fire pit gets the position. Do it now, please. Bravo, Whitfield. You've completed the test. Welcome to Black Phantom.
Thank you, sir.
Now, if you would excuse me, I have a visit to pay to a certain FIB agent. It would seem someone needs a pep talk.
So, a busy time for you, Mr. Secretary. What with this election campaign of yours?
Oh yes, the election. I was wondering how long it would take for you to bring this up. Before you ask, no, I am not running for office purely to scrutinize you.
I'm chuffed.
What I am doing is running for office to fix this broken country. I mean, look at it. We're massively in debt. The globalists are screaming for more international relations. We've got unemployment rising to the millions, and worst of all, our security agencies cannot tell the difference between good and bad.
Look, I respect you for running for office, Piers, especially as you're already a member of President Morrison's administration. But that doesn't mean you get to wave your political beliefs in my face and expect me to play ball.
Face it, Mrs. Angel, your agency is in tatters.
Quite the contrary. It's on the up and up. More criminals are being prosecuted than ever before. Local community crime rates are down, and the agent program is taking out high-level international targets without fault. What's the complaint about?
How about the fact you and your agents let terrorists escape with an FIB helicopter? Not very efficient, is it?
I can assure you, Mr. Secretary, that my agency is running as efficiently as ever.
This agency, like every other department, is under intense scrutiny. You have been allowed to run rampant in the past, and look where that's got us.
The methods of this agency have improved the lives of millions and saved the lives of many more.
And if people ever realized that, Mrs. Angel, we would have a constitutional nightmare on our hands.
It's direct, Angel. If you have a problem with the way my agents handle their work, then I suggest you restore my budget.
Your methods have gained a reputation beyond this government. Terrorist groups are crawling out of the woodwork to size you up. Our economy is failing. The sanctions on businesses are increasing our finances slightly. But taxes alone are not going to keep this country afloat. We have to make cutbacks. Unless, of course, you're expecting the president to start selling his kidneys.
With respect, Mr. Secretary, it might just stop him from taking the... What is it? We're a little busy right now.
It's 11, ma'am. He's on his way in.
Thank you. Did he say anything else?
Yes, ma'am. Black Phantom.
He said what?
You are dismissed, agent.
Sir.
Running efficiently, saving lives...
Mr. Secretary, I...
Save it. You and this 11 have just endangered the lives of every agent in this organization, not to mention compromising our national security. This agency has continued despite many monumental cock-ups, and I'll be damned if I'm to let it continue. As of this moment, operations are suspended pending the outcome of a Senate hearing tomorrow morning. I'll leave you to tell your agent, Mrs. Angel.
Don't patronize me, Agent 11. Now, let's turn your attention to your new watch.
Oh, Professor, you shouldn't have.
Do try to take this seriously, 11. Remember where you are. But if it's really that difficult, it's a good job I made a few modifications. Your watch now contains the very latest tracking software.
What would I do without you, Professor?
I often ask myself the same question.
Mom?
At ease, Niko. Nice watch.
Thank you, Mom. The professor and I were just getting some stuff together, just as protocol states.
Not this time, unfortunately.
I'm not following you, Mom. In the event of a Black Phantom...
In the event of a Black Phantom, the most senior agents must do whatever is necessary to protect the agency.
Exactly. So...
So nothing. The Secretary of Homeland Security has suspended us, effective immediately. You and I are to attend a Senate hearing tomorrow morning.
Certainly, ma'am.
Oh, Niko.
Yes, ma'am?
Before you leave tonight, I'm going to need a full report outlining the events of the operation.
Will do.
Looks like I'm staying.
Sorry about the mess. I wasn't expecting guests, Mr.
Delaware. It's all right. I would have phoned, but whenever I do, people do stupid things, like call the police.
You think I won't?
I think you're already in enough shit without having the blood of a small police unit on your hands.
You're not here for tea and a chit-chat, I presume.
They told me you don't mess about.
You're very well informed indeed. So, in the spirit of not messing about, what do you want?
Nothing from you, Mr. Bellic.
Two bikers and an interrogator are dead. Because of me. Now you turn up here wanting nothing?
I'm simply here to tell you that you've lost, Bellic. We have the chip. We know every agent, every bank account, every safety deposit box used by the FIB. We even know all about your illegal escapades abroad.
That's a lot of information to just sit on.
You're stuck in the past, Bellic. The market has moved on. No longer is there value in weaponry or who's got the biggest bomb. The scariest thing about certain world leaders are their haircuts. You see, value lies in power, and information is power. Week by week, a piece of information will be leaked to the public. After a month, we'll start to leak information daily, unless the government pays the sum of $81 billion. The Black Phantom Group does not wish to hurt this great country, but we will do what is necessary.
The Black Phantom Group?
Do you like the name? It was based upon that protocol your FIB is about to undertake. Oh, is that the time? I'd best be off. Goodbye, Mr. Bellic.
Order. Order. The Senate is now in session. The actions of the Senate are to be carried out under the instruction of the Honorable President of the United States of America. I call Mr. Robert Pierce.
I am here today to formally request that the FIB be disavowed with immediate effect. Over the past few years, the actions of the organization have been unjust. They have allowed many terrorist groups to contaminate their service. They allowed Agent Tony Ronson to betray the organization, who then later escaped prison.
Mrs. Angel, can you inform the Senate of your role in the organization?
I was a director.
And as director, you had overall authority on the operations undertaken by your agency? Could these operations be considered illegal in any way?
My agents have fought tooth and nail to keep this country safe. When I was kidnapped, they got me back. We prevented nuclear war without so much as a thank you. We put an end to honor and the chemical attack they were planning.
You didn't answer my question, Mrs. Angel.
My agents do what they feel is necessary to complete their operations. This may require them to operate outside the country.
You mean to say that the FIB has been carrying out operations in direct violation of our Constitution, not to mention international law?
This country is not speaking another language because of my agents.
That is neither here nor there. The fact remains that though the actions of the FIB have prevented a war, they could just as easily have started one. During your time in command, you have lost agents and left others seriously injured. The evidence submitted includes that of a Miss Karen Michelle, who as a result of an escaped fugitive, now relies on the use of a pacemaker. Finally, an agent, Michael Townley, was killed in action after a gas attack.
Both operatives knew the risks. They both put their lives on the line for this country.
In operations that should never have been undertaken. Mr. Piers, I ask you to outline to the Senate your proposal that the FIB be disavowed.
Members of the Senate, I propose that should the FIB be disavowed, I will attend an emergency cabinet meeting. There, I will outline security reforms. In the meantime, the IAA will take on the workload of the FIB until any outstanding operations are complete. I myself will personally appoint Mrs. Angel's replacement to ensure this never happens again.
The Senate accepts the proposal given. In light of the evidence and this proposal from the Secretary of Homeland Security, I hereby declare that the FIB be immediately
disavowed? What do you mean disavowed? Government bureaucracy gone mad! That decision was made by politicians who've never done this job and never could.
Niko, you need to get back here as soon as you can. Claudia's going to want to have a word with you. Be warned, as you didn't turn up to the hearing, you're not in her good books.
That's a little complicated. One of the men from the mission I was on turned up at my house.
Oh my god. Niko, are you okay?
I was knocked out. Woke up in a prison cell. Just another day at the office.
Is that 11?
Yes, ma'am.
If he's not here in 20 minutes, I'll hunt him down and kill him myself.
He's in a prison, ma'am.
He's where?
He was attacked last night after he left.
Call the professor. We need to get him out. Sit tight, 11.
Not going anywhere, ma'am.
Good. Excuse me a moment. I've got a message from Piers.
You have one new message. Message 1. 12:32 p.m. From 07181525182.
You have an incoming call from 07181525182.
Mission failed, Agent. You spent years telling people you are the Lord Beric, but you're not above it.
Mom, hang up the phone, now!
I'm not following you, 11.
That number is the same number that called me after I failed to get the chip back.
Are you certain, Agent 11?
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, it is possible that the cellular transmission was hijacked.
We can't take that chance.
You called, ma'am.
Ah, Professor, it appears we have a situation. I need you to run the number that called Nico's phone. Analyze the voice, see if you can get a match.
Yes, ma'am.
11, as Karen has told you, we've been disavowed. We can't get you out.
There is one option.
What is it?
Valkyrie.
No, not happening.
With respect, ma'am, you don't have a choice. I know him. He can be trusted.
Ma'am, it appears the Secretary of Homeland Security has forgotten about the homeland. And the security. He's probably not even the Secretary.
Noted. Okay, Niko, you're right. I'll get the professor to contact him and send him in. In the meantime, Karen.
Yes, ma'am?
Make sure this place is cleared. Piers may be a traitor, but he brought up a good point. Too many traitors have passed through those doors.
Will do.
Niko?
Still here.
Valkyrie will do what he can to get you out, but be warned, he is your responsibility.
Affirmative. 11 out.
Niko Bellic!
Enrique?
I was hoping we'd never meet again.
You wouldn't be the first.
How's my plane?
Rubble.
Never trust an Americano.
If you have something to say, Enrique, I'm all ears.
You know what? Yeah, I do have something to say. My men died saving your ass. I gave you a plane in return for one thing. your protection. Instead, I end up here, compadre.
I'm sorry. I didn't expect them to turn up. I had to get Luna to safety.
I hope she was worth it. I will have to apologize to her personally when I get out.
For?
Even a man of my profession has a code, Niko. A set of rules and morals I must abide by. I'm afraid you broke a deal. Nobody breaks a deal with me, Niko.
I promised you protection. People like you need protection from yourselves. You're welcome.
All prisoners return to your cell blocks. This is an emergency lockdown. Proceed to your nearest entrance. I repeat, this is not a drill. All prisoners return to your cell blocks.
Busted the door and took out the electromagnetic locks on the cell doors.
How did that work out?
Because I was the one that done it.
Yeah.
got your message. Good to see you again, old friend.
Next time you fancy a reunion, Bellic, buy me a pint. Hands outside, Niko. Let's move.
Thanks again for getting me out.
Well, I should probably be thanking you. Retirement is not all it's cracked up to be.
What's the plan?
Your contact.
The professor.
The professor told me to get you out of that prison and drop you off at the airfield RV.
Which I'm guessing is that one.
Nothing gets past you, does it?
Professor? Karen?
Agent 11, good to see you're still with us.
If I didn't know any better, I'd say you were doubting me, Professor.
Not at all.
Are you going to introduce us?
Codename Valkyrie, former 22nd SAS Regiment, an old friend from the good old days. He's a deniable ops specialist and the very best at what he does. He's also the number two for this mission.
The what?
We're going after a man with immense wealth, power, and influence. I need a partner in the field. You hate retirement so much, so I'm offering you a way back in.
What about...
No, we don't know properly who he is and what's going to happen. You might be okay for small ops, Karen, but if it all hits the fan out there, then your pacemaker puts your life at risk.
A risk I am willing to take.
I'm not. What do you say? You in?
Who dares wins.
Where's Claudia?
She's staying behind in LS. Fighting the political battle, so to speak.
Claudia has a meeting with President Morrison in a few hours on Air Force One. Nothing official, just an off-the-record chat. She won't say anything about Piers until we have hard evidence.
Luckily for us, we have the opportunity to expose him. Legally, Black Phantom is a constitutional protocol used by the entire government and security services. This means that we have clearance to do whatever is necessary to bring Piers down, despite being disavowed.
Is that ours?
Yes.
Let's get her in the air. We'll brief in flight. Karen, head back to LS. We may know the truth, but Claudia is going to need some help getting the government to listen. Right, let's review what we know.
2 days ago, you were sent, along with another agent, to recover a data chip containing details of every operation ran by the FIB and the agents who performed them.
The interrogator got the code to use the chip after the agent cracked. He was then killed in action. I chased the men, but couldn't retrieve the chip myself.
You then received a phone call from a number that matches that of Robert Piers, making him our prime target and assumed leader of the Black Phantom Group.
Good going. Do we know much about this Black Phantom Group?
I've been working on that. I ran a deeper check into Mr. Piers. It appears he is of dual citizenship.
What's that got to do with the Black Phantom Group?
After achieving his degree in politics, Piers moved to Morocco. He stayed there for 20 years and in that time gained Moroccan US citizenship and was a member of the Assembly of Representatives of Morocco.
So, he's done this before?
It's probable. Morocco is not exactly the biggest country to bring down. I suspect Robert is thinking...
The bigger they are? The harder they fall.
Exactly. Now, I managed to access his state agenda from the government database.
Professor W, you've been a busy boy.
Quite. It appears he has a personal meeting in...
Let me guess. Morocco.
Morocco.
Then that's where we're going. You got that, Valkyrie?
Copy that.
setting a course now.
Niko, correct me if I'm wrong, but if the government are to believe the director, then they're going to want evidence.
Then that's exactly what we'll give them.
Credible and sufficient evidence. If Piers really is a traitor and is responsible for stealing the chip, then we've got to do everything we can to stop him. He cannot get this presidency, Niko.
Believe me, Professor. I know. I understand the consequences of this if we fail. Because if we don't succeed, then not only will the FIB become obsolete and be absorbed into another agency, but an international terrorist operating this sinister organization will become the leader of the free world. We can't have that. I can't have that.
I concur, Niko. We do whatever it takes to stop him. Oh, Agent 11, one last thing.
What is it?
Interpol. He must have done something wrong, because it looks like they're onto him too.
Niko, Professor, the flight time will be around 12 hours. Get some rest while you can.
It's a beautiful morning here in Los Santos, and today we welcome President Morrison, who has just arrived on Air Force One at Los Santos International Airport. The President is due to attend his San Andreas rally later today, as his opposing candidate, William Fitzgerald, is speaking in Liberty City to a flurry of his voters. Strangely enough, though, the third candidate, Robert Piers, has rescheduled his rally in Vice City to next week, as apparently he has come down with a serious case of the flu.
Claudia, my dear.
Felix, how are you?
I'm very well, thank you. I'm glad you could make it at such short notice. I'm doing a rally here in a few hours, and since I was in town, I thought I'd ask to see you. I hope I haven't interrupted anything.
Not at all. We're just currently running an investigation.
An investigation? Thought you guys were disavowed.
I had to initiate Black Phantom, Felix.
What? Why? Black Phantom hasn't been used before. Ever.
I know, and I understand we are only meant to use it when it is absolutely vital, but trust me, it is.
Well, what's the story?
There's no hard evidence yet, but we believe there may be a leak within the government itself.
Jesus.
We're not too sure who yet, but when we have enough evidence, we'll make the arrest. I've got my best agents on the case.
Ah, yes. Agent 11, am I right?
Yes, how did you...
My security advisors have been keeping me posted on all the agents in the FIB's agent program. If he's on the case, then I have nothing to worry about.
So, are you going to tell me why you really wanted to see me, Felix?
Claudia, I know how much blood, sweat, and tears you have had to sacrifice to build the FIB, but I believe your talents are being wasted away. How do I put this? If I win this election and go into my second term, my administration needs a new Secretary for Homeland Security. I want you to fill that role.
I don't know what to say.
It's a big ask, I know. But this country needs a person of your caliber to run the entirety of its defenses and security. I trust you more than anyone I know, Claudia. Together, I know we can do great things, not just for this country, but for the world.
As much as I appreciate the offer...
Fantastic. I'll start the...
I'm going to have to decline it, Felix.
What?
Don't get me wrong. Working directly with you would be a dream come true. But you said it yourself. I've put blood, sweat and tears into making the FIB into what it is. It's thanks to my agency that this country is standing strong. Not only that, but people in the agency rely on me, Felix. I cannot let them down.
Well, that's a shame. But I totally understand. You've always been loyal to your cause... And you've never let a project go unfinished.
Some things don't change.
Well, I respect that. You do what you do best. Investigate and bring people to justice. If you are right in saying that there is a leak within our government, then you do whatever you feel is necessary to bring them to justice. Get as much evidence as you can.
Trust me, Felix. I'll get you more than evidence. I'll give you the man himself.
Thank you for seeing me, Claudia. Please never change.
I don't intend to, Felix. Best of luck.
And you, Claudia.
So, what did he have to say?
He offered me a job.
What?
As the new Secretary for Homeland Security.
Jesus, that's brilliant. I
turned it down, Karen.
What? Why?
The FIB needs me. More importantly, Niko and the team need me. I'm not going to let them down. This is who I am, Karen.
I understand. I think you made the right call.
As did I.
Did you mention that we have a leak in the government?
I did, though I didn't mention who it was. He told me to collect as much evidence as we need, so that's exactly what we'll do.
Thank God he's on our side. Oh, whilst you were in the meeting, Neil Everest called.
Who?
Robert Pierce's personal assistant. He wants to meet downtown Los Santos in an hour. He said it was urgent.
We'd best get to it.
I mean...
Hello, Niko.
But... No. It can't be. Ellie?
In the flesh.
But how? The plane. You were...
Come on, Niko. Let's go inside and I'll explain.
Niko. You all right, mate? You look like you've seen a ghost.
How?
With this.
This is pure titanium, reinforced with carbon nanotubes. It's also got a monomolecular blade. With that and the titanium, you should be able to stab through any form of body armor, and very possibly an aircraft chassis.
But you didn't know.
I recognize the metal, pure titanium.
I was given that knife before I'd even met you. How did you get it?
That night we spent together when you left in a hurry. You left it.
For once, Levin, I'm glad you rarely return your equipment.
Just before the plane exploded, I was able to cut a hole through the chassis and get out.
Why didn't you come back to us? To me?
The only reason you got through that was because Hessler and Drax were in your head and they knew it. They kept you alive because they enjoyed tormenting you. I knew that if I was to protect you, I had to let you believe I was dead.
Why here? Why now?
When Interpol heard your secretary was holding you to ransom, we ran his name through our database.
And?
And nothing. His past in Morocco was well hidden.
If there's no evidence in Morocco, then why are you here?
You. I knew you would come and investigate. Niko, I came for you.
Well, everyone has their own favorite type of person.
Who's this?
This is Valkyrie, a very old and very loyal friend.
What Nico's trying to say is, I used to carry him back in the old days.
Nice to meet you, Valkyrie. Professor.
Elizabeth.
Haven't we got a job to do?
Although, as I've just said, there's no evidence in Morocco.
Interpol was focusing on his political work, not his private organization.
His private agenda has him attending a meeting somewhere nearby.
I was taking a drive out earlier. Security has really been stepped up at the Taj place in Marrakesh. I'm willing to bet that's where the meeting is taking place.
That makes sense. What's the plan?
We're going to bug that meeting. No doubt they'll be discussing the chip. There'll be all the evidence we need to put him away, and hopefully get reinstated.
Even if the FIB is not officially reinstated, the government will probably re-establish the agency under a new name.
What? Like the FBI?
Don't be ridiculous, Eleven, that's a stupid name.
Well, that's all well and good, but we don't have any equipment.
That's where you're wrong. I sent a message back to Claudia with a list of resources we'll need. She agreed to send them here at a level 1 priority.
There was a crate just left here when I arrived.
I saw it by the car as we parked.
Good. Agent 11, if you would follow me, please.
Time for my holiday souvenirs.
Indeed. Now, with the FIB disavowed, it's very difficult to get the quota of equipment you're used to.
We can work whatever we've got.
Good, because we don't exactly have a choice. Your gun. A modified M9 pistol. You'll also be carrying tear gas and, if things get messy, sticky bombs.
That's not a lot.
Hold your horses, Eleven. You will also need cameras, which you will need to install at strategic places within the hotel. That will allow us to pick up where Piers' men are placed. This USB drive contains a program that will allow me to patch into the hotel's electricity supply. Our intelligence tells us that every time Robert's head of security uses the room, he charges his phone. Using the power supply, I can run a program allowing us to use his phone to listen in on the meeting.
How do I upload it?
Connecting it to any computer terminal should do.
Okay, anything else?
If you would follow me, please. Your car. Once again, you have the agency Kurama. This one, however, comes with radar equipment and a CCTV system.
I suppose it also comes with a tracker so you can locate me.
No.
What?
Before the FIB was disavowed, I was working on a project. It's a prototype, but I think I've got the principle right.
What is it?
A DNA locator. You know how dust is made up of microscopic...
bits and bobs, yes.
Bits and bobs? Niko, microbiology is the most fundamental area of human science. Try and get a little perspective. Anyway, dust particles also contain, among other things, skin. Using a sample of your skin cells, the software will be able to permanently track your location as you pass through the air, and leave a trail of your cells behind. So long as you remain alive.
That doesn't sound safe. Or hygienic, actually.
Nonsense. Now hold out your hand, this won't hurt a bit.
Ow!
I lied. Now, we need to get this operation underway.
Agreed. Let's move out.
Sir, I have received a communication from General Pierce. He requests you meet him at his private villa in Morocco ASAP.
Thank you for notifying me, Agent. Have a plane ready and waiting for me immediately.
Yes, sir.
Claudia Angel.
That's Mrs. Angel to you.
Miss Angel, my name is Neil Everest. I am Mr. Pierre's personal assistant.
And I suppose you're about to toll the bell on our future?
I have been asked to address this issue, yes.
Robert's too much of a cow to do that himself, is he?
Mr. Pierce is away on a business meeting.
That's the yes, then. I thought he had the flu.
I have been told to inform you that a private firm is looking to be contracted to carry out your duties.
So Robert's idea of making cutbacks is to pay over the odds for a private firm? How brilliantly predictable from a low-class politician. Has the President been made aware of this? He mentioned no such thing to me in our meeting we just had.
Preliminary plans have been drawn up. The President will receive said plans and give his opinion on it in the coming days.
My agency and I will not go down quietly.
Your agency can go down kicking and screaming for all we care. You've been disavowed. Your agency is no more.
Stop! This is getting us nowhere, ma'am. What will happen next?
You are to meet at the former FIB building tomorrow morning along with every agent you have. A private task force will be dispatched to eliminate anyone who doesn't show. No loose ends.
Warn 11. He's to bring Piers down, whatever it takes.
Yes, ma'am.
Right. I've pulled the schematics of the hotel and have located the villa the meeting is being held in.
Good work. We'll get ready.
Niko, that was the good news. The bad news is that to get there unseen, you will have to swim through 50,000 gallons of pressurized water.
No one ever said this was going to be easy, but I wasn't expecting this.
Me neither. Professor, are you sure there's no other way in?
I'm certain. I ran all the possibilities.
It's your call.
Just like the old days. We do whatever it takes.
We stop for no one.
We never waver.
And we never back down.
Huh. You remembered.
I've never forgotten.
We'll do it.
I thought as much. Your equipment is over there. Okay. Your objective is to plant the cameras in the corridor leading up to and inside the room in which the meeting is due to take place. Then, find a computer terminal and plant the electronic bug into the system. I can guide it to the right destination from here. You must do all this without being seen. Understood?
Got it. In and out without being seen or noticed.
You've got all that to come.
Please focus, Valkyrie.
Sorry, Prof.
It's Professor. I will be monitoring the equipment. Elizabeth will be monitoring the CCTV system, so listen to her closely.
It's great to be finally back in the game.
It's great to have you back. Now, let's move.
How do they know each other?
I have no idea.
Agent 11, comms check.
Codename Valkyrie, comms check.
I hear you.
That's a shame. Prof?
It's Professor... Never mind. I can hear you both. Remember, it's 50,000 gallons of pressure between you and the RV. Keep your speed up.
Copy that. Ready?
I'll meet you at the bottom.
He never changes. Right behind you.
That's our opening.
Pressure safe. Oxygen levels 75%. 11, all's going to plan. Just slow your breathing down a little. How's the CCTV feed at the exit?
No one by the pool. They should get in pretty quickly.
Copy. We're approaching the surface now.
Shadow above the surface. I thought you said we were clear.
One of the guards just stepped out for a cigarette. He's preoccupied, so you can take him out easily.
Copy.
This is 11. We're back on dry land.
Make your way inside and watch out for the private security. Place the devices as I told you, a camera in each corridor and one in the room itself. The bug needs to be uploaded to a computer.
We should split up. You take the cameras, I'll upload the bug.
Agreed. Prof, the cameras are in place. What next?
It's Professor. Go back to the pool and extract. 11 is yet to upload the bug, but I expect he shouldn't be too far behind.
Fair enough.
Professor, this is 11. The bug is in the system.
Good work, 11. Valkyrie has completed his objective and is extracting via the pool. I suggest you do the same.
Roger that. Change in occupation?
Yeah, I fancied not being shot at for a change.
In the spirit of not being shot, I would suggest you start cleaning. 11, there's a bathroom on your right.
Oi, what are you doing here so late?
Private contractor, mate. Something about an important meeting taking place tomorrow. I don't like to ask too many questions, you know?
All right then, I'll leave it to you.
Niko, time to go.
Either that's a gun against my head, or you're freakishly tall. That's a shame. I thought we could do basketball tryouts together.
Good to have you back on dry land.
What about Niko? Did he...
I don't know.
It's done.
So, how did the meeting with the president go,
He offered me a job, Simon.
Are you fucking serious? A job? Not as the White House cleaner, I hope.
No. No, as the new Secretary for Homeland Security if he wins the election.
Jesus, did you take it?
No, I didn't.
Why not?
Because I'd much rather keep the agency I've dedicated my whole life to upholding, thank you very much.
Well, in all honesty, I'm quite glad you didn't take the job, because Morrison won't get it this time.
What makes you say that?
Because he's up against two people who actually speak like the common people. None of this political correctness bullshit. Fitzgerald, although his trade policies are quite good, won't win because he lacks the social connection with the people. Piers, on the other hand, he'll win by a landslide.
You mean to say Robert Piers will lose due to the fact he stabbed his boss in the back by leaving his administration to venture off onto his own? Plus, there's the fact that Piers holds no moral compass and has domestic policies that are more adventurous as a hard-left socialist party? Please!
Piers is an honest man, Claudia. People see that. The reason he left Morrison's administration because he knew Morrison was an idiot.
Well, now I know who you're backing.
I'll happily say it. I'm backing Robert Piers.
The man who got my agency disavowed,
Look, that wasn't his fault.
He directly attacked me, Simon. That son of a bitch cannot be trusted, let me tell you.
Look, you shouldn't have been disavowed. It's outrageous, I know. Trust me, I'd be as angry as you are right now.
Unfortunately, dear, it wasn't my choice. It was your favorite candidate.
Look, honey...
I know. I'm sorry. I shouldn't have shouted. Things are just stressful right now. The FIB has had too many issues in the past. It's this constant motion of one step forward, two steps back.
Maybe you should start using lower level terrorists to gain valuable information. It's what I...
I do not give a damn what the IAA would do. My agency does not work nor negotiate with terrorists. Shouldn't you be packing anyway?
I'm packed. The IAA should be sending a car anytime soon. Ah, right on cue. I'll see you next week. I love you.
Love you too. Claudia Angel speaking.
Ma'am, 11 and the team in Morocco are all set. It's 7 a.m. in Morocco. They're about to move in on Robert as we speak.
Good. Robert should be keeping a close eye on our chip. Tell the team they are to obtain the chip if possible.
Yes, ma'am. I'll let them know immediately. Good night.
Good night, Karen.
Security update?
It stepped up, which is good.
How is that good?
Well, it means the meeting is still going ahead and that your getting noticed last night didn't cock this thing up.
The quicker we move, the better chance we have.
Is the equipment holding up?
I designed the equipment myself. It's working.
Right, the plan. The professor and I will go to the villa, get ourselves in range of the equipment. We can then record and stream the meeting to you. At the same time, you need to monitor the security cameras inside and out.
Will do.
Valkyrie, stick with her. If they work out what we're up to, they'll trace the signal back here. Think you can manage that?
Think that cheek will still work with my foot in your ass?
Right, let's do this. Ellie, I have eyes on the building.
Good. The convoy is stuck in traffic 3 miles out. It's rush hour, so they might be a while.
which gives you and Valkyrie plenty of time to explain how you know each other.
No.
I agree, Eleven. We're a team. We should know exactly who we're working with.
No, now's not the time.
Now is as good a time as any.
Niko, the prof is right. They should know.
Before the FIB, I grew up in the UK. When my parents were killed, I was sent away for protection. I did some things I wasn't proud of, which led to my arrest the minute I arrived in the US. The FIB offered me a deal in exchange for my freedom. The other agents gave me a cold reception due to my past. This led to the director sending me on an indefinite exchange to the British Army. That was the first place I ever felt I had a family. After a few operations, I passed selection for the SAS. Life got quiet after that. Most of my ops were dealing with hostage situations in London. Nothing exciting.
So, what, that's it?
Valkyrie?
It's okay, Niko. They deserve to know.
Then, out of nowhere, I got a call from someone within MI6. I was asked to join an elite team, performing deniable ops across the globe. The team consisted of four men, and four men only. Valkyrie, Harrier, Firecrest, and me.
We took our names from military aircraft.
What was yours?
Valiant.
What next?
We carried out ops so deniable that even the deniable ops guys wanted nothing to do with them. In fact, we were even based at the very safe house we've just been staying at. Our final deployment was in Russia, taking down the leader of a terrorist close to the Russian government. The stakes were high.
How high?
At best, piss Russia off and leave them trigger-happy and unstable in the coming months. At worst, we'd start a full-scale nuclear war there and then.
So what happened then?
Mid-flight, we realized there was something wrong in the cargo bay. One of the terrorists had gotten on board. They knew all along we were in Russia. There was a fight. I opened the door of the plane. Just before he fell, he managed to grab hold of both Harrier and Firecrest. Their death was my fault. I left the SAS after that. By then, Claudia was running the FIB. She offered me the chance to come back. She gave me a chance when no one else would.
Niko, I'm...
I know.
Bellic, the convoy should be turning in now.
I've got eyes on the convoy. Convoy is static.
Static? After all this time, he reads the handbook.
Wait a minute. I recognize him. That's the man that kidnapped me. Richard Delaware.
If he sent his head of security to kidnap you personally, then we know he's not messing about.
Agreed.
Thank you.
Delaware should put his phone on charge any moment.
Professor, I'm receiving audio now. The cameras are also active.
I'm glad you could make it, Delaware.
It wasn't a problem, sir. My apologies for the delay.
Not at all, Delaware. I have complete faith in you.
Thank you, sir.
As my most trusted advisor, I thought it would be best to inform you of the next phase of our plan, and of course, our organization.
I'm honored, sir.
As you should be, Delaware. Now, as I'm sure you are aware, Black Phantom has formally issued the ransom demand to the United States government. I, however, cannot be seen to influence him in any way or risk my exposure, for my election campaign will be destroyed.
Is that a problem?
The opposite, actually. The truth is, I have a buyer lined up for the chip if the government doesn't pay. It's not quite $80 billion, but a healthy sum nonetheless. Enough to fund my campaign, anyway.
Very well, sir. As head of security, I must ask you, what are my instructions regarding Niko Bellic?
Bellic and his band of merry men are to be killed on sight, if they interrupt operations. But alas, the chip is safe and we remain one step ahead of them at all times.
Should I send a team to look for him?
That would deter us from our main objective. It wouldn't be efficient. And you know how I feel about efficiency. Bellic will get his turn.
But sir...
Trust me, Delaware. When the information from the chip is leaked, lives will be exposed. Women and children will be in danger. Whose fault is that? When this gets out, every agent still alive will want him dead. Why waste our resources?
Very well, sir. May I ask, what are we to do regarding our lordship?
Please, Delaware, do not speak of that name. We do not take orders from him anymore. We are our own organization.
But, sir...
Delaware!
I am simply saying, sir, that our lordship will not take the news lightly. He will not rest until we're dealt with if we go rogue, sir.
We have our security. I'm certain once I have won the election, we will become untouchable. Invincible. The most powerful organization in the world.
Stay very quiet, stand by the wall, and stay very, very still.
It would be more efficient, however, to increase the security of the data chip. I wouldn't want to violate my buyer's consumer rights. I trust you can take care of that, Delaware.
Yes, sir. Where's the chip now?
I had one of my contacts agree to keep it for me at a military base in the United Kingdom. RAF Sheppey, I believe it's called.
I'll have a team dispatched straight away.
Shut up. Shut up, shut up, shut up! Is your phone meant to lock when stationary?
Yes, sir.
I know you can hear me, Bellic. I said I'd have you killed if you got in my way. I gave you a chance, but it appears keeping you alive is proving to be inefficient. And you know how I feel about efficiency.
Car! Now!
Niko, you've got incoming.
Copy that. Professor, let's go. Valkyrie, we are mobile. You two need to get out of there now.
Roger that.
The professor will send you the location of an emergency rendezvous.
We'll see you there.
Valkyrie, we're being tailed.
Niko? If you're going to do something, Eleven, now would be a bloody good time!
Professor?
Yes?
Clench!
Niko?
Oh shit, oh shit!
Thank you. Niko?
Professor, jump!
Oh shit, oh shit, oh shit!
Next time, Eleven, read the road signs.
Tell you what, next time, I'll let you drive.
Don't patronise me, Agent Eleven.
There it is.
We decided to ditch the car and approach on foot to avoid drawing attention. I see you did the same.
Yeah. That's exactly what we did.
Let's review this footage before the dust damages the equipment.
Play the recording.
Now, as I'm sure you are aware, Black Phantom has formally issued the ransom demand to the United States government. I, however, cannot be seen to influence him in any way or risk my exposure, for my election campaign will be destroyed.
Where's the chip now?
I had one of my contacts agree to keep it for me at a military base in the United Kingdom. RAF Sheppey, I believe it's called.
Do we get all the evidence we need?
It looks like it. We just need to upload it to the IAA database.
That shouldn't be too hard for you.
In theory, no. But I need to upload the evidence using a similar database, as a sort of data catalyst.
We could use the chip.
That should work. Yes.
Then, in that case, we kill two birds with one stone.
Looks like we're heading to the UK.
Better tell your sister to get the kettle on, Valkyrie. Tell her Nico's coming.
Tell her yourself. Then perhaps you'd like to give her an explanation as to why my foot is in your ass.
When you two are finished acting like children, we have a chip to find.
Couldn't have put it better myself.
It's almost a shame that the best fighting force in the world let three imposters in so easily.
Let's save the "this country has gone to the dogs" speech for when the job is done.
You bring up a fair point. These disguises won't last for long.
Let's go over the plan once more.
You and I will search for the chip whilst the professor guides us using the chip's IP address.
I'll cut off all access to and from the base, then go after Robert.
Professor, do we have the green light?
Indeed, Eleven. You're good to go.
Gentlemen.
Gentlemen.
Eleven, I've tracked the IP address to a building just down that alley. Straight ahead and to your left.
Copy that.
Your custom knife, Eleven. Use that. It'll get through any lock, remember?
Simply put it through the keyhole, and I'll use the remote hacking software to open it.
Professor, we don't have much time.
Hang in there. I'm going as fast as I can. Got it.
Stay here and keep watch.
Prof, I'm not gonna be able to take them out quietly.
Never mind. I've sent a sleeper virus to your phone. Plug it into the control panel and the virus will instantly shut down the gate when you give the instruction.
Ah. I'm sorry to say that weekend privileges have been removed. All soldiers are confined to the base indefinitely. Prof, the base is secure.
Professor, good work. Niko is about to retrieve the chip.
Ah!
Niko, what's wrong?
The chip! It's not here!
No, it has to be there. It's there, Eleven, trust me. The IP address, the chip's IP address is matching that building.
Professor, the chip isn't here!
Eleven, what do you see?
An old computer terminal. Just an old one.
That's not good. Okay, Eleven, I need you to check the hard drive. Is there any sign of the chip being plugged in?
Negative. There's no sign.
But the IP address is identical.
Is that even possible?
It would take some doing, but it's not difficult. Which makes this
a setup! Elizabeth!
Well, well, well. If it isn't Bellic, Niko Bellic. It's been so long.
I'm sure you'll get over it.
Oh, I don't doubt it. I was hoping you'd show.
I hate to disappoint.
Really? That's not what I'm getting from all this. You failed once, and now you failed again. In fact, you've probably done more to help the Black Phantom Group than the FIB in recent weeks.
The Black Phantom Group? Naming your organization after a protocol that protects national security. It's a bit ironic, don't you think?
You would think. No, Mr. Pierce has been planning this for a very long time. No, for me, Black Phantom is a reminder.
Of what?
The day the great Niko Bellic brought his country to its knees. Now, you're going to join my employer for dinner at one of our local bases.
And what's my incentive? I presume that if I refuse, you'll kill me.
Your incentive, Mr. Bellic, would be that I don't force you to watch as my men pump their magazines into your girlfriend.
Table for two it is, then.
Blinded by love again, Bellic. Arrest them. Have Bellic ready to meet the boss. And cancel my weekend in the Lake District. I need to be back on the coast of Africa for our guest ASAP.
great Niko Bellic. Ah, I suppose you're just letting me save your ass too.
Shut up and start firing.
I gotta roll up.
Oh, you've got to be kidding me.
Eleven, I can see you from here. What the hell do you think you're doing? Agent 11, do you copy? Do you copy? Over. Niko!
Professor! Keep tracking that plane!
Copy that, but what on earth are you planning to do?
I need you to cut that engine. I have a plan, and it doesn't involve being torn to shreds!
Eleven, you're going to get yourself killed. What the hell do you think you're playing at?
Niko, get down from there.
Professor, I need the door to this plane open. Now!
I'm trying. The plane runs on a separate isolated system. It's not going to be easy.
But you can do it, right?
I said it wasn't going to be easy. I never said it was impossible.
Access denied.
Professor, hurry up! Slipping!
Niko, remember the reserve parachute under the jacket.
Warning. External threat detected. Activate autopilot.
11, the pilots have raised the fireball. I can't bypass it.
Professor, door! Now!
Niko, I can't. The pilot has activated the autopilot.
Thank you.
Ah, Niko Bellic, please, take a seat.
Is this how you treat all your guests?
They don't normally stay for dinner. I think it's the decor.
I've seen worse.
Do forgive me, Mr. Bellic. I don't actually think we've ever had a formal introduction.
We don't need one, do we, Piers?
Can't say I didn't try. What's next?
The data chip. Where is it?
Straight down to business. I like you. Very efficient.
So?
Not here. You've lost it, Bellic. It'll make this easier on everyone if you change the record.
And they told me at the door you were terrible at hospitality.
Who told you that?
The guard? Outside the door?
He spoke to you.
Yes?
Well, that's just rude. Fire the guard shift. They gossip. Gossiping is inefficient.
Hardly the world's best boss.
Oh, I give a glowing reference. I know all my employees by name. I'm a people person. I also know of you, Niko. How's the old man?
My father's been dead for years.
What a storied life you've had so far, Niko. A young boy so touched by death, yet so willing to inflict it onto others.
I keep people safe. They deserved it.
You're very quick to say, which would be fair enough if you were consistent. Yet just last year you let the Spectre walk away again.
He had his reasons, just as I have mine.
The humble agent. Personally, I think the title is beneath you. You should consider something more charismatic, like an animal name, or something more noble. The heir of scorpions, perhaps.
Call me whatever you like. You'll be arrested soon anyway.
By who? I'm a U.S. government official. The FIB isn't trusted, and Niko Bellic is now a fugitive. Do you still have that problem with the mole?
Agent 23 has been charged. I presumed you already knew. Or is the government not as all-seeing, all-knowing as you'd have us believe?
I knew of a mole. Even Mrs. Angel can keep a secret or two from the government when it benefits her. You of all people know that. It's why we're here, after all.
So what's the plan, then? Sell the chip, move away. Nice place in the sun, I'm guessing.
Turning my country around, Niko. Prisons fill too quickly nowadays. I don't think we should waste our resources on small-time crooks. Instead, we should focus on the bigger terrorist organizations.
So, that's what Black Phantom is all about.
Claudia Angel. The FIB has always struggled in its duty to protect our citizens. Its time has passed. Many powerful forces are trying each and every day to bring us down. Mrs. Angel is as good as helping them. The people of this great country elected an arse. Too scared to see the truth. Black Phantom is that truth. Even the president would see that eventually, if his best agent was to balls up and lose the country's most sensitive data. Therefore, you could say that in creating Black Phantom, I was, changing social policy.
You'll excuse me if I don't trust a politician.
I doubt you'll be voting.
No.
I'm going to have you killed now, Niko. You'll be executed outside. I would do it in here, but we've only just changed the carpet from the last one. You should have seen him. He made such a mess. Although, from what I recall, Bellics don't stain that much anyway. I digress. Go with this guard here. I don't want you getting lost. Oh, and Niko, say hi to Mummy and Daddy for me. It's been so long.
Personally, I'd rather have a firing squad.
Can you see him?
Just a second.
Why? I mean, you look like a crap shot. I'll give you that. But I'm sure even you can shoot me at this distance. Camo looks good on you.
I think the idea of camouflage is you're not meant to be seen in it.
You're right. Out is so much better.
That your expert opinion, Mr. Bellic?
Needs testing.
In detail?
3 times, plus an average.
I'm not sure the guests will appreciate it.
Ah, where are they?
That mountain, over there.
Shot from that distance is
attractive.
Expected.
Jealous.
Foreigner 23.
Not at all.
You know, I've had my best IT guys take a look at that data chip, and they stumbled across a highly classified file. Yours? There's a lot of women mentioned in here. Catherine Ronson, Luna Gamadia, Karen Michelle. Have you told that fine young lady about them yet? No. No, you wouldn't have. Stuff in here. No wonder they don't last long.
Where are you, Robert? Come on! Face me! Killing you with the perfect entry to my file!
Mind you, there was one, wasn't there? She looks beautiful, I might add. The one you loved above all others. I've learned a lot about you today, Niko. After reading about her, I realized she's your real story. The first and only time Niko Bellic has ever truly loved. So I thought, let's find out what Niko Bellic is really like. A world exclusive. It took some time and a lot of phone calls, but I got there. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, I give you Mr. and Mrs. Bellic.
I still have no idea how this happened. Seriously, pinch me.
Because I saw a man in the bar and thought, why not?
Oh, I see. It was your decision.
Absolutely.
Turn it off!
Oh, you haven't told her yet, have you, Niko? About your wife?
Well, in that case, I'm left with no choice.
Niko, what are you doing? You're acting funny.
I love you.
I love you.
Earpiece! Now, Elizabeth! Hurry up! What the hell is taking you so long? Get this turned off now!
Niko, I can't.
Save it! I don't want to hear anything but a yes! I didn't ask if you could do it! I asked you to do it! Is that understood?
Niko!
Is that understood?
Yes, I'll do what I can.
Then get it done! And while you're at it, find out how the hell he has this and who recorded it.
Niko, wait!
Then, seeing as this was all your decision, make one more for me. Kiki Jenkins, will you marry me?
Who recorded that call? Come on, you coward! Tell me!
Telling you now would be inefficient.
Niko, stop! Please! You're killing him!
Why should I? He never would!
Niko, what would she say? What would Kiki say if she could see you right now? She saw you for the good man that you can be. The man I know you can be. She wouldn't want this. Any of this. I know you loved her, Niko. I know she will always be with you. She would want you to end it, yes. But end it the right way. She loved you then, Niko. Just as I love you now.
We're not finished. I'm coming for you. Mark my words. Let's go.
Send everyone after them.
Professor, we're getting out. Now.
There's a boat by the lake we could use to get the hell out of here.
Move!
That should get us out.
I'm not that good with heights. Holy shit!
We're running out of options. Robert is always one step ahead of us all the time, and he knows it.
She's right, Niko. This is bordering on suicidal.
You feel this way too? I take it none of you have wondered why we're here.
As breathtaking as this place is, it's not exactly time for a holiday. We're actually in a Black Phantom-owned safe house.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. What?
Have you gone mad, Niko?
I was wondering why the decor was so terrible.
As we were being arrested by Delaware, he mentioned cancelling his weekend in the Lake District as he needed to visit the coast of Africa. I thought if we came here, we'd find out where he would be heading, and I wasn't disappointed.
So, where is he going?
There's a desk in one of the other rooms. Inside the top drawer was a map, with a small series of islands circled the Savage Islands in the west coast of Africa.
The Savage Islands? No, never heard of them.
They're not officially used by anyone, that's why. It would be a great place to hide anything. Weapons, safe houses.
Black Phantom headquarters?
Precisely. I think this is where Black Phantom's lair is.
Great, we know where the bastard is, let's go.
Wait, there's more. The word buyer was written underneath. If we don't stop them, they're going to sell the chip and it will be lost forever and the FIB will remain disavowed. Not to mention that Piers may become the next president of the United States.
Shit.
Agent 11, if I'm right in saying, and I usually am, but are you suggesting we invade the enemy's headquarters?
You read my mind, Professor.
That's balls, mate.
Since one of you backed down from a challenge. If we don't do this, then we'll lose everything. We'll be dead, and I can't let that happen. So, are you in?
Always.
Forever.
Back to that promising career in espionage.
Ah, Delaware. Give us a moment, please. Give me an update.
The Black Phantom European headquarters was destroyed, sir. We lost about a dozen men or so.
What about Niko Bellic and his team?
They managed to escape via the open waters, sir. I had my men deploy marine units, but by the time they were dispatched, Niko and his team were gone. I'm sorry, sir. We've lost them.
Niko is beginning to question everything. His late wife, who I am, who we work for. No matter, though. Our job here is nearly done, and he has no evidence, yes?
That is correct, sir.
How marvelous. What's the status on our buyer?
We received a telecommunication from the buyer about an hour ago. He's on his way here now. ETA, 7 hours, sir.
Very efficient timing. By the time we have sold the chip, my next rally will be held. The FIB secrets will be leaked, and Niko and his team will be branded terrorists, out to incite the destabilization of governments around the globe. I like this. Anything else?
No, sir. Shall I have our men set up the meeting area?
Please do, Delaware. And increase security. We cannot have this plan being compromised. Not now. We're too far into it.
Of course, sir.
Okay, so the professor managed to draw up satellite imagery of the Savage Islands and found a disused military base being operated in. It appears to be some sort of cave.
Did he just say cave?
He did. It's actually quite ingenious if you think about it. The mountainous terrain means signal is weak in the area, and thermal satellite imagery cannot bring up any schematics because of the island itself. It's fascinating.
Once we've landed, we'll use the submersibles to go around the back of the island, disembark, then climb to a point where we have visual range of the base itself.
Do we know anything about the buyer?
Nothing. Robert is keeping his cards very close to his chest.
He's been careful up to now. I doubt he'll show his hand. We assume the buyer is hostile.
Understood. So, what's the plan?
You'll provide sniper overwatch at the base. There's one entrance and one exit, so you'll keep Valkyrie and I posted on what you see. Professor, you'll go and gain access to their security network and run the op from there.
Problem. How do you know how to access it?
My satellite scan picked up images of an electrical transformer unit on the top of the mountain. My guess is that they're using a simple band wave frequency generator. So I'll simply plug in and gain access the old-fashioned way.
Tech stuff. Got it. Niko, what about us?
We'll breach the base via the main entrance, but we'll need some sort of distraction.
I've got that covered.
Brilliant. I don't have to tell you what we're up against here. If we fail, then this malevolent despot will gain access to the most powerful position in the world, the presidency. Black Phantom will rise and take over. The FIB and all it stands for will be in tatters. We will all be killed. Whatever happens, we do not leave this island until Piers and the buyer are dead and the chip is recovered. Understood?
Completely.
Of course.
For the greater good, Niko.
Niko Bellic.
11, it's me. It's not good news. I can't get the heat off you for any longer. No one at the IAA is returning my calls. Our window is closing. Whatever you're doing, do it fast.
Don't worry, ma'am. Everything is under control. I promise you, in 24 hours, the Black Phantom group will be over before it even gets started. You trusted me all them years ago. Now trust me again.
I've always trusted you, Niko.
If you don't mind me asking, ma'am, how are you doing?
It's tough, Niko. I've worked in this business my entire life, to try and make a difference. But each time you slay the Hydra's head, it grows two more.
We'll get there, ma'am. The world hasn't seen the last of Director Claudia Angel.
Good luck, Agent 11.
Thank you, ma'am.
Love these suits, Prof.
Yes, well, just remember that your glasses have the inbuilt camera, so we'll be recording everything you see for evidence. Your suits are also lined with reinforced carbon Kevlar material.
Bulletproof?
Bulletproof. Hopefully you won't need its protection.
Right, let's unload these submersibles and get going.
Watch your heading, people. Black Phantom may be using sonar scanners, so stay away from the east side.
Now you tell me. Fuck me. When you said a lair, I didn't know you meant a fucking military base.
Neither did I.
There's no way you can go through the main entrance. Look how many guards are posted there.
Hold on. Professor, are those transmitter beacons on top of the entrance?
Yes. Yes, they are, Eleven. What are you thinking?
The plan stays the same, but just with a slight adjustment. Come on.
Thank you. dumbass!
Sir, the buyer has arrived.
Right on time. How efficient. Get the chip, Delaware.
Of course, sir.
It's showtime, folks.
Guys, heads up. Two tangos have arrived.
Do you have a visual on the buyer?
Not yet.
Damn it. Professor, have you gained access to their network yet?
I'm working on it. Black Phantom are using a complicated asymmetrical encrypted algorithm.
English, please, Professor.
It's difficult. But not difficult enough. And there we go. I'm in. Accessing CCTV network now.
Good man. Run a facial ID on the buyer, please.
Niko, when do I set off the distraction?
Not yet. We need facial recognition first before we move in.
Okay, I've got a visual of the buyer on the CCTV. I'll run the facial recognition software.
How long is this going to take, Professor?
It's difficult to say, Eleven. Ah, the facial recognition has come through. What the...
Professor? What's wrong?
That can't be right. He's on staff.
He's what?
He's on the IAA's staff database. Niko... It's Simon Angel.
Simon, my friend. Glad you're here.
Robert, it's nice to finally see your home from home.
Ah, yes. Black Phantom's HQ. Trust me, it's more lavishly equipped than you think. Shall we?
Of course. After you.
There must have been some kind of error in the search.
Professor, what's the match percentage rate?
98%.
God damn it. What do we do?
This does not change anything. He is still hostile. Is that understood?
Niko, that's Claudia's husband in there.
Yes, exactly my point. Simon Angel has been conspiring with a terrorist organization. He's buying the chip to use against Claudia. How do you think she would feel knowing Simon got away?
Nico's right, guys. This doesn't change a thing.
Okay, fair enough. Claudia's going to be distraught.
Professor, Valkyrie, prepare the distraction.
So how's the election going?
So far, so good. After your funding comes through, we predict a mass surge in public votes.
Perfect. I'll be sure to vote for you on the election day.
It's appreciated. I am glad to see at least one powerful American still see sense.
So, let's get down to business. I have the money. Do you have what I came for?
The chip? Of course. It's there on the desk. It's yours as soon as the funds arrive.
I had my men store in our boat. Can't trust banks these days. I'll make the call for them to unload it.
Marvelous.
Yes. It's me. Do it. What will you do with the money?
Well, for the first quarter, I shall treat it as an initial investment. The Black Phantom Group will become the most powerful private organization on the planet, allowing me to conduct my business affairs without any pathetic FIB-inspired financial sanctions. After that, I'll be using my funds to support my election campaign, increasing my chances of becoming the next President of the United States of America. Brilliant.
Leadership was never my wife's strongest attribute.
It is a good thing she will never find herself in a position of power again then, especially with me as president.
Which reminds me, I've been meaning to thank you for recommending the IAA as the sole security service in the US.
Not a problem, my friend. It is much more efficient after all, and you know how I feel about efficiency. With me in power, Claudia and her pathetic agency will be dissolved, and the United States of America will come to welcome the newest breed of intelligence and counter-extremist agencies, the IAA, spearheaded by Director Simon Angel.
It has a nice ring to it.
What will you do with the chip?
The IAA will increase its intelligence. It will then be able to work with smaller fish to take out the bigger sharks in the waters. Hell-bent freedom fighters will assist us in taking out archaic dictators. That sort of stuff. An idea my wife never approved of.
I'm sure you are aware that aside from that chip, you have my complete political support.
Thank you, sir. The same to you.
Come, take the chip as we watch our investment unload.
Of course.
Heads up. Robert and Simon are walking towards the entrance. Now's your chance.
Copy that. Professor, activate the bug.
Activating the bug. Now.
Jesus!
What the fuck was that?
I think our headsets just failed.
Right, the transmitters must be down. Come on!
Valkyrie, do it.
Everything seems normal here, sir.
Seems someone has broken the transmitter. Wait a minute.
Heh. Attaboy.
What the hell was that?
Sounded like an explosion.
Shit! Bellic is here.
Sir, come with me. Now.
What the hell is Bellic doing here?
I'm out!
Reloading.
More exciting than retirement, eh?
Are you kidding me?
I need all units to the main cave. Now, I repeat, we have an internal security breach.
There's sniper fire from the outside, sir, but we're working on it.
God damn it. Sir, I'm sorry to say, but we might not be able to get you all out of here.
What? If they discover my identity, we are done. Do you hear me? Our plan will have failed and we will be executed for treason. Fuck!
Simon, please, calm down. Delaware, I have a plan.
Sir?
The emergency docking area.
No, sir.
The emergency docking area?
That is an emergency protocol for you, sir. With all due respect, you're my boss. It's my duty to protect you, and in the worst case scenario that we lose this place, I have to get you out of here.
And that, Delaware, is where my plan really prospers.
Niko? Simon just fled from the cabin at the top of the walkway. He's going down to some sort of tunnel.
Where does it lead to, Professor?
It leads to some sort of emergency docking station around the back of the island. I think he's trying to escape.
We cannot let Simon escape with the chip, Professor.
Ellie, are you able to double back and get there?
Negative, Professor. I'm dealing with the backup units that are trying to enter the base.
We're out of time, guys. If we want the chip, we're gonna have to make sure he doesn't get on that boat. Prof, it's gonna have to be you.
Guys, I'm not sure I can do this. That's Claudia's husband.
Professor, that man has betrayed his country. He's willing to work with terrorists to gain power over his own wife. Do you think Claudia will thank you for that if we let him go?
No. No, you're right. I'm on my way.
Watch your corners, mate.
Don't worry about me, lad.
Gentlemen, welcome! That was quite an explosive entrance, even if I do say so myself.
It's over, Piers. Hand over the chip.
What chip? You can search the space all you like, but the chip is not here, I can assure you.
Don't worry. We know Simon Angel's got it.
Ah yes, Mr. Angel. No, he just popped around to offer his political support to my campaign. He's a charming man.
Perhaps. But then again, charming men often have something to hide, much like his traitorous escapades with you.
I'm not quite sure what you're on about.
So, how does it work? Using the money from the chip to fund your organization, making it stronger and more powerful on the global stage?
Or using the money to fund your political campaign as president?
What about both? I mean, it's human nature, really. Greed, lust, power.
Do I need a lawyer?
Not where you're going.
I'm surprised you've made it this far, fellas. And it's a magnificent show, it really is. But it's had its time now. Much like Claudia Angel and the pathetic agency of the FIB.
Is that what this is all about to you? Just taking down an agency?
No, it's about removing the parasite that has driven this country into sickness. Even its politics has crashed this train. I'm gonna change that. Me. Robert Pierce.
Well, I'm afraid the fun is about to come to a dead end.
Pleasure of you both to join us. Now put your guns down.
Funny how karma comes full circle, wouldn't you say?
Simon, stop!
professor, let me guess. I don't have to do this. I have a wife that loves me. Blah, 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 blah.
Simon, please!
Save it. Instead, at least make your last words count.
It was always going to end this way, Mr. Bellic. I have answers to questions you have, but you're never going to be able to get them. Soon, you'll be branded a terrorist under my government.
Just a regular Tuesday, really. Getting used to it now.
Mr. Delaware?
Sir?
Have these mongrels killed and dumped in the fire pit, please. Or the other way around. Your choice.
With pleasure, sir.
I would love to stay and chat, gentlemen, but I have an election to win and a very pissed off Claudia to arrest. It's the most efficient thing to do, really, and we all know how I feel about efficiency.
Guys, Simon's dead, but I've recovered the chip. It's secure.
So how would you like it done, boys? Tortured first, then a quick cap in the head, or thrown in the fire pit and left there to burn?
Fire pit. Yep. Sounds like we're gonna have the most heated time, right, Valkyrie?
Right you are, lad.
Nah. Think I'll torture you first. What the?
too stuck in the past now, Delaware. You okay, mate?
I'm good.
What the hell happened to you guys?
Got in a bit of a tumble. Nothing major. Where's Piers?
Gone, I'm afraid. I didn't have a clear shot on him.
Professor, are you okay?
I shot him.
It's okay. It wasn't your fault. You had no choice. It was him or us.
But Claudia?
Claudia would expect nothing less from you or any of us.
Package secure. Mission complete.
Team.
Where's Claudia?
The Senate. She sends her regards as well. News that some of our loose ends are being tied up. The FIB will be reinstated.
But what about the charges against us?
Due to the evidence you have collected, the Supreme Court has decided it is in the national interest to drop any and all charges against you. Director Angel would also like to congratulate you for your efforts and commend you on your outstanding bravery during this operation. I think that's everything. Any questions?
What happened to Robert?
Honestly, we don't know. Satellite imagery lost his private aircraft after it left the islands in the North Atlantic. But wherever he is, we'll find him.
What about his candidacy?
Withdrawn. The official statement for now is personal issues that are affecting his ability to run for office. Petty, I know, but the world will soon know the truth.
As long as that bastard ends up in a body bag, I'll be happy.
Shit! Drax! You scared the living daylights out of me!
Hello, Robert. You haven't been returning our calls.
I've been busy.
We're aware.
I've been trying to get in contact with the Lordship over the past few days, but haven't been able to reach him.
I know.
So, why are you here?
You chose to not follow the plan. Disobeyed a direct order.
For my own reasons, but good reasons. I was going to sell the chip and then use the money to fund my campaign. If I got into power as the President of the United States, then our lordship would...
Robert, you don't want to lie to me right now. I'm in a good mood. You do not want to see me in a bad one. You had one job, Robert. Bring us the chip.
Yes, I know, but...
And yet, you failed. You thought you were above us.
No.
You thought nobody could topple you.
No.
You thought you could get away by using us, our trust, our resources, all to fund your own greed and lust for power. How selfish.
Drax, I promise you, I was doing it for the right reasons.
Have you heard of the myth of Icarus, Robert?
No.
It's fascinating, but tells a moral story. Icarus was given waxen wings to fly out from the hell he was in. But he was warned about hubris, greed. Fly too high and the wings will melt. And yet, after constant warning, Icarus gave in to his greed. He decided to fly as high as he could, to try and be as high as the gods. Inevitably, the sun's heat melted his wings and he fell to his death. How could someone be so naive,
It's human nature, I suppose.
Human nature. The death of humanity. How ironic. You thought you could fly higher than us, Robert, but your wings are melting. You're close to falling.
Drax, just let me call your lordship. Let me call him.
No.
Please let me call him.
No.
Drax, please!
No.
Drax, let me fucking call him! You don't have to do this.
Robert, you knew what was going to happen the moment you saw me in the room.
Please, I can fix this. I swear, just please let me call...
My lordship, it's done. Tell Hunt the plan is finally underway.
Mom? Can we talk?
Ah, Professor. What is it?
Mom, I just wanted to say... about Simon. I'm really sorry. I truly am. I didn't want to.
It's okay, Professor. You did exactly what was necessary, despite the personal challenges. I've met field agents who have got themselves killed by making the wrong decision in that situation. What you did has saved this country. It has saved the lives of everyone in this agency, including my own. My own husband put them in danger, and for that I can never forgive him. He always enjoyed power. In the end, it corrupted and blinded him.
Thank you for being so understanding, Mom. I'll leave you in peace.
So, how long are you going to stay with me?
No, Mr. Bellic. The real question is, how long are you going to stay with me? Working with you these past few weeks have been the best time of my life.
It has been my pleasure to work with you, Ellie.
That being said, my place is not with Interpol any longer.
I see. So, where is your place?
Until today, I had no idea. I woke up today with the intention of leaving this business, but then Claudia offered me a position, and then I realized.
Realized what?
My place is with you, Niko. To stand by your side whenever, wherever.
Till death do us part.
Niko, did you just...
In time. One day, when this is all done.
I'll be waiting.
Take the car and go ahead. I'll meet you back at the apartment.
Last time we shared an apartment together.
I'm counting on it. I wasn't expecting you to stick around.
Yeah, I figured I'd stay for a few more days.
I still think about them. Every day.
As do I. They'd be proud of you, you know?
Really?
You didn't know it, but you had a negative reputation with the regiment as well when you started. You proved yourself, Niko, as you have done once again. They were both very proud of you.
I still remember the very first thing Firecrest told me. Our business was born in the shadows. It must evolve to survive in the light.
Yeah, he also said that someday you would repeat that phrase when you finally understood what it meant.
He was right. This fight doesn't end, even when the eyes are on us.
For you, no. For me, crappy retirement.
Unless
what?
I need a partner. I work better as a team. You were the best team I ever had. We traveled the world together. Niko Bellic. Yes, ma'am. Certainly, ma'am. Just a moment. Valkyrie, the professor has found something. Claudia sounds shaken. Something's come up, and it's big. You in?
Who dares wins.
Ma'am, we're on our way.
Yes, my lordship. Yes. Thank you, sir. I will not let you down.
Ladies and gentlemen, as the President of the United States of America, it is my great honor to welcome a new person into my administration. Ladies and gentlemen, please give a warm welcome to the new Secretary of Energy, Mr. James Hunt.
Thank you, Felix.
You deserve this, James. Go on.
Well, what can I say? I'm Secretary of Energy James Hunt.
My lordship, tell Hunt the plan is finally underway.
And the future, for all of us, is going to be very, very bright.